Thank you, Lord Jesus. Matthew chapter 8, verse 8. My initial word, I'm going to read it myself before. Isn't it help me? Matthew 8, 8. The centurion answered and said, Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof, but speak the word only. Matthew 8, 8. Speak the word only. Friends, I collided with this revelation this morning. Speak the word only. As if I've never seen it before. As if I've never seen that word only before. It caught my spirit. And I came to the conclusion that what alone can do it.
Yes.
I don't know where again. This revelation. My spirit caught it. Just speak the word only. It didn't say add any jara. No pepper, no salt. Just only the word. Friends, God tells you and I that the word to God alone and only can bring you deliverance, can bring you salvation, can bring you restoration. It says, this is a true man, a hidden. Just speak the word only. It caught my spirit. I said, oh God, why am I looking for alternatives? Why am I looking for other solutions? I said, I got it. I got it. Yes, I want to say, God, thank you. Thank you, God. I go, that the word only can bring me all I need. And Jesus responded and spoke. And at the same time, I was healing. It never had to go anywhere. Friends, you have to place the man for the anointing on Jesus. Jesus was on his way to go there. He said, no, don't come, don't worry. I know you. You created the word, everything came through you. Just stay there and speak. And Jesus said, what a great faith. Others will say, please come to my house, touch my daughter, touch my son, touch me here. Praise God. He said, no, don't worry about that. Just stay there and say it. I believe in you. Friends, what only was what caught my attention, that God's word only can bring you the deliverance you need.
Amen.
Can bring you salvation that you need.
Amen.
Can bring you restoration that you need.
Amen.
So why are you looking for anywhere else? Why won't you be here when you see God's word only? Jesus. I can't even express what I'm feeling. When the morning I was jubilating, I said, thank you, Jesus. That means I have the powerful, one and only powerful revelation, the best ministry, the best hospital. Name it. What am I looking? I'm not saying the hospital is wrong, though. Why am I going to the hospital? He said, what only? So I don't need the doctor. I don't need the pharmacist. I'm sorry, pharmacist. Left to me, you're not getting the job. I'm not saying it's wrong, girl. It's okay. Amen. I'm not saying that's my own. It caught my spirit. And I've been brooded by saying, God, word only. Your word can save. Your word only can save. It can deliver. It can heal. It can restore. I've been brooded over this. I say, hey, brood over the cheek. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And what caught me is that this man challenged Jesus. You want to go to my house? Don't worry now, master. You're a master over all things. Just stay there and say it. Do you want to go to my house? And I told myself, if that is the case, that means the master who's above there, watching over us, does not need to be here physically.
Yes.
All I need for you to send for this word.
Yes.
Just send it. It doesn't matter where you are. It can be at Jericho, be at London, be at, just send it.
Yes.
And Bible says, send for this word and deliver them. And deliver them from all that destructions. Every destruction attacking your life, by the reason of God's word, they shall be destroyed. They shall be destroyed. They shall be destroyed. I declare I delivered. You are delivered. You are delivered. You are healed. In the name of Jesus. Shout, I hear you well. But we serve a true and living God who was the same yesterday, the same today, the same forevermore. If Jesus did it for centurion, this man soldier, it's your turn. I say it's your turn. Shout, word only. Thank you, precious Father. And he said, my servant shall. shall be healed. What a faith. What a great faith. Thank you, precious Father. Thank you. When you're running here and there, it's time to concentrate. Don't be running here and there as if somebody is pursuing you. Concentrate, which means it's not the fellowship you go to. Am I committing? It's not the fellowship you go to. It's not the wars that you know, the physical wars. It's are you staying with what the word? The word. You can be in your room and catch the word. You can be in your master room and catch the word. You can be in your restroom and catch the word. Am I going to get it?
Yes,
how do you catch it by yourself or hear somebody preaching it and you catch it?
Yes.
You are there already.
Amen.
You are there already.
Amen.
Tell somebody stop running around.
Stop running around.
Stay and catch the word.
Yeah.
And be delivered.
And be delivered.
Amen.
Amen.
Clap for Jesus. I don't want to excited today. What do you want? I feel like I'm joining fellowship, one only fellowship. Praise the Lord. To God be the glory.
Amen.
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 I'm going to thank this after my foundation program. This is the first full meeting we're having. I want to seize the opportunity to thank all of you for making it possible. Kind of taking time out of your tight schedule to come and grace the occasion. And all of you were my guest of honors.
Amen.
And, it came powerfully. Powerfully. Amen.
Amen.
You know, he didn't just come to give more support. He came to give. More support. You know, I told the story of a man that gave more support. He gave all the speech in the world. And I said, I'm giving my moral support. I'm like, all this speech. When you finish, you bring some mamu kino. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So all of you brought mamu kino. To God be the glory. And then on behalf of my family and Philip Foundation, we now say we want to thank the fellowship the special way by donating this thing you are seeing here. You like it? How much did you see? We are passport testament. We're not in the New Testament.
Yes, sir.
Don't you like it? So, I told you before that when you that Hannah had to look for what is missing in the church. Am I communicating?
Yes.
For 400 years, the heaven was closed.
Yes.
No voice. And I said, I will bring you a prophet. I will break the voice of heaven. And God said, yes, since you said that, you'll be pregnant.
Amen.
So am I communicating? And look, I said, what will be the need of the fellowship? I said, this one will be the need. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Come on, clap for Jesus. Yes, sir. Yes, yes, yes. Please decree on her this in because my time, no, her sister is ready for me today. Let me finish before she catch me. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Okay, by the grace of God, we began a new series. Who can remind me of this new series for September? Okay, understanding the force of the alignment. Amen. And we began last Saturday, and that was our part one, and we looked at the crisis. Amen. Tonight, we look at something else again, by the grace of God, which I'm going to title, by the grace of God, I'm going to spell it out so that you don't think I'm using big English. It's a simple English. You know, I title it, though I told you before, we have a theme for the month, we have a topic for each week. It's under the theme. So under the theme of this, understanding the force of divine alignment, I've already defined what alignment is all about, and the force, you know.
So tonight, I'm not going to much definition because of our time is really short, so I can go straight to the topic. So I've been looking at what I call the constraints. Constraints, you know, when you constrain somebody. When you constrain, you know, constrain. Does anybody need me to spell it out? Yeah. You know, anybody that uses that, I can spell it. Amen? Amen. I don't want to spell it, I'm not going to misspell it. And then tell that me. Amen? The constraints. Constraints. No, for the word constraint, you get constraints. To constrain somebody. To restrict somebody, you know? Amen. Is that okay? Are we together now?
Yes.
Okay. That English is very simple. We use it day to day. It just means there are three meaning of it, three categories of the meaning, which I want to read out very quickly. I will go into the dictionary meaning of it, and I decided to group them into three categories. So the first one it can mean limitations. Copying something, you know, cutting it short. Check, to put something under check. And then also restrictions. That's a popular one about constraint. Constraint something means to restrict the person. And then control. To constrain means to control. And then second category of it says, it can also mean uncertainties. Conflicts, you know. And the third category means, it can also mean force, to force. To compel, you know, like something's compulsory, you know. Praise God. And then, as a matter of fact, at the end of the day, these three categories of the meaning of constraint leaves out something very significant. One thing stands out among the definition. One thing stands out that in this situation, uncertainty, you know, conflict, limitations, curb, check, restriction, whatever you can, to force, to compel. It leaves one word or two words, you know, common among them. It means that the person who's under these three categories have no choice. Am I correct? No choice. That's what it is. This thing have no choice. You are constrained, you are forced, you are compelled, you are under a force of compulsion. You are compelled, you are restricted. You are restrained, so you have no choice of your own. So you're under the mercy of the person who is trying to handle you. Amen. So let us look at the scripture. Let's go to Matthew. Can you imagine how you use that word constrain in Matthew chapter 14? So some other versions use different words, but I love the way it's being represented there as is that word constrain. So Matthew Gospel. Amen. Chapter 13. Shale Bragadusa Katala Bragadusa Katala. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Let us read from, I'm trying to see who can be fast. Let's read from Jesus. Manly Bragadusha Baya. Let's read from verse 20 to 36. Isn't it here?
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The one who received the seed that fell on the rocky places.
Is that Matthew 13? Matthew 14, sorry. 14. Okay. I'm sorry.
Matthew 14.
Sorry, 20. That's my mistake. 14, 20 to 36.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. They all ate and were satisfied. And the disciples picked up 12 basketfuls of broken pieces that were left over. The number of those who ate was about 5,000 men, besides women and children. Immediately, Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go on ahead of him to the other side, while he dismissed the crowd. After he had dismissed them, he went up on a mountainside by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone. But the boat was already a considerable distance from land, buffeted by the waves because the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went out to them, walking on the lake. When the disciples saw him walking on the lake, they were terrified. It's a ghost, they said, and cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, take courage, it is I. Don't be afraid.
Yeah. 36, is that 36?
But 36. It's you, Peter replied. Tell me to come to you on the water. Come, he said. Then Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, and came towards Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid and beginning to sink and cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. "You of little faith," he said, "why did you doubt?" And when they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Then those who were in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." When they had crossed over, they landed at Gennesaret. And when the men of that place recognized Jesus, they sent word to all the surrounding country. People brought all their sick to him and begged him to let the sick just touch the edge of his cloak. And all who touched him were healed.
Hallelujah. Amen. I see you touching the Lord tonight.
Amen.
I see you touching the Lord tonight.
Amen.
Amen. You know, testimony is when you see somebody do something and get a result, you follow the person.
Yes.
The woman of issue of blood touched him and the rest saw that he walked. They all get that to do something. Amen. If it works for one, it can work for many. It can work for many people. Am I communicating? So give God praise. Tonight, we're looking at the force of alignment. And I did tell us last time that we have heard so much of God's word. By the grace of God, we hear it online. We come here and listen to God's word. We have been through many series by the grace of God. And we have heard so much of God's word. And I said, the problem is not just hearing God's word, but the problem is alignment. You know, how do we align ourselves? How do we reposition ourselves so that we can begin to get results? How do we put ourselves in place to get results? Now, and I told us that oftentimes, God may not just wait for you to get yourself repositioned, you know, to start getting results, to get yourself aligned, that he might introduce element of force. Amen. It might be some elements of push, some element of compulsion, where you yourself have no choice. That's what I said with the word no choice. Because he loves you and I. He wants to take us somewhere. He wants us to get to somewhere. So what he does is to begin to introduce elements of no choice. Because left to you, left to me, we make do what we have. We live it, we like, a lot of people like to live a life of mediocre. No, I have this, I got this, I'm okay with it. I don't need to move forward. I'm just okay, I'm comfortable. Oftentimes, God does not want you and I to be, just remain there in one place. He wants us to move forward. Amen. Am I communicating? He wants us to move forward, to move forward, to move forward. So, time has come for the apostles to move forward, for his disciples to move forward. After he has, you know, we had the issue of killing of John the Baptist, and, you know, so he secluded himself to a place, there was no food. Gave them, fed them, the apostles contributed in feeding them. He said, sit down. Apostle was able to see all this he was doing. They've seen this thing, like became normal. Feeding on the 5,000, you know, people came to be healed. Sometimes they tried to prevent them from going to get healed or try to tell them, master, don't whatever. So they felt comfortable. They began to become more of an organizational structure. You know, to build up organizational structures. So they started talking about who is the greatest. You know, it became comfortable. They were like, okay, we got it. Everything is fine. The master is here. You know, you know what I'm trying to say? So it became more of normal. Praise the Lord. Now, a time came when they had issue of with the same storm. But this time around, the master was in the same boat with them. You know that other scenario. Master was in the same boat with them when that storm happened. And he just rebuked the wind. So, you see, in our journey of life, we face small boats, what we call baby boats. As we move around, some more boat, and there's much more winds and storm here and there. In which Jesus can will be there, we just rebuke the wind that is over. You know, and then we get over and say, yes, we are there, the master did this, and that was over. Now, Christian John will witness these things here and there. You know, as we journey now, if he leaves you alone by yourself, you will make do with small wind and small waves and small things this way. This, and then each time you go through small things, be expecting small results. I'm going somewhere tonight. Each time you go through small things, be expecting small results. Big things bring big results. You see, when God takes you those steps, from step to step, he has to take you through challenges to get to the next step. Challenges takes you from one step to another. It's easier to just fall back and slide back than climbing upstairs or climbing a ladder. Am I communicating? And each time you climb the ladder, you are taking steps upon steps, and you are going to the next phase of life. So it's difficult for people to just begin to climb steps like that. Rather, they want to just go down instead of going up. Am I communicating? So the Lord is saying to us, instead of us sleeping, you know, just slacking behind, going back, or even in one place, He wants to take us further. Praise God. And in taking us further, He has to introduce an element of constraints. Praise God. Right. Follow me, I'm going somewhere. Element of constraints. Jesus, help us. That's what the Bible says in Matthew chapter 14, as we read, in verse 22. The Bible says, and straight away, Jesus did not even blink his eyes. Straight away, verse 22, Jesus constrained his disciples to get to the ship. In other words, you all get to the ship. Enough of play. Enough of normalcy. Enough of this. Enough of that. No, I see some of the apostles were just okay with, you know, okay, you know, we were able to feed 5,000. The master gave us the bread, you know, the bread to share, the fish to share. You know, we got this, you know, we are in charge. Anytime you want something, come to us. We take the master. If you want food, come to us. They'll be like more of a gate. They become like more like a gate man. Gate man. Amen. So they were just saddled and okay with where they were in. Jesus said, okay, I need to take you all beyond what you know. And to give you an experience, to have an encounter. And the master did not blink his eyes. He said, straight away, it's like Jesus saying, commanding you, go to the ship, all of you, go. The previous one, he was there in the boat with them. And they said, oh, no, man, we got this. The master did this for us, don't be the wind, it was over. Well, we know that, how could a man just command his wind to stop, whatever. No, they were just happy with that. Not only the master had planned something else for them. This time around, he will not be in the boat. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Second to ship. And then to go before him on the other side while he sent the multitude away. You see, friends, let us never be among the multitudes. He sent the multitude away and he constrained the disciples. Allah bragado shaba. Ladies and gentlemen, if any time the master sends you away, did not give you some level of challenges, some level of climbing up to the next ladder, next phase of life, go and cry. Because you are a multitude. If everything all your life is bread and butter, sugar, your Christianity is full of bread and butter, no challenge in life, no next level. They're just okay, you're playing a mediocre level. Come and pray, you don't pray. Come and sing, you don't sing. Come and read Bible, you can't read it. You're just there all by yourself. You're just okay. Let the sleeping God dog lie. You are among the multitude. Go and cry for yourself. Because there's no challenge whatsoever in your life. The masters told the multitude, go away. No challenge for you, just go. Live your normal life. Eat and drink and make merry. If you are one of them, go and cry. Am I communicating? But for those who are in a carcass, in a chamber, he constrained. Jesus Christ. Then you all get to the boat. Because you are about to have a big encounter. Amen. The master being omnipotent with science, all knowing God knew you were going to encounter the storm. He knew it. If you say it doesn't know me, it's not God. He knew. But he orchestrated it for a purpose so that they can begin to move to the next level of life. Bible said they need to get over to that side of vision. Oftentimes, when you're about to move to that side of life, God has a way of constraining you, bringing some things here and there, could be restrictions here and there, some kind of coping, checkmate, just checking you out. Could be some kind of conflict around your life, some kind of, you know, one little problem, challenges here and there. You will bring along your way. And friends, what made it so strong is that at this point, no choice.
Yes.
No choice at all. That's why it's a force of alignment, force of divine alignment. That will be a compulsion, a constraint, that will be a compelling force pulling you because the master wants to get over to the other side of life. Friends, you have been too saddled here, too much in mediocrity, you have been too much other side of the region. Everything has come normal, no improvement, no growth. Your spiritual life is not growing, you're just saddled in one place. Your spiritual life is not improving. When you sing, your singing is like something that I told you, a singing minister, it's not moving. Am I communicating? As a physical minister, you're not even mixed, you're not even winning souls, you're just there. Like somebody. I don't use the word fat before they will crucify me. You're dead, Bugudum, like somebody. If I use fat, then they will crucify me, so I don't want to use fat. You have to be politically correct in America. You know how now somebody, how they feel somebody. Am I communicating? No, the one that is longer is called someone. The one that is big is called somebody. Am I communicating? I'm not saying those who are there are always with you, but what I'm trying to say is that I'm not using a picture to tell people what I'm trying to say. What I'm saying is people are used to just remaining where they are. No moving forward, no going. They just want to stay in one place. But the master will not do that to those who are his disciples. Those who are serious in serving him, in working with him. He will constrain you from time to time. I'm telling you the truth, he will compel you, he will push you, he will move you. Some of you say, Brother, you're pushing us too much. Let the master meet you. You push more than me. When the master, the master will catch you, he will push more than me, sir. Have I communicated? Yes, so the master is a pusher. He likes to push you. As long as you have given your life to Jesus. Now, I told you before, different between let me say it again. You see, the day you say, Father, I'm born again today, in other words, you have just received life of Jesus to your life. Okay? And that is different from giving your life to Jesus. I said it before, I told you the difference, right? When you become born again, you just accept the life of Jesus to your life. Righteousness, holiness. But the day you make up your mind to give your life to him, you know what you have just done? You have told the master, take over my life and make demands as when necessary, as when you want it. Make demands. So the master will start making demands. One of the demands will make it so constrain you. Because you have given your life to him, he will constrain you. He will force you. No, now what is the reason? The reason to put you under alignment. It's to panabit this way, panabit that way, panabit this way, to put you under alignment. I'll give you an example of a vehicle that needs alignment. You see, that we are, you have been steering this way, the vehicle turn this way. That means the vehicle is not under alignment. So for you to put correct to control it, you have to push it this way to come back, right? Some of you have, so when you put it as a force, you are forcing the vehicle to come under alignment because the vehicle is not under alignment. The same way, people go this way, God says, no, you must come back this way. Yeah. Or you say, you must go back this way. So the master is in control. There must be an element of force to put you into alignment. That's why we're looking to this very September period. God, what do we do? How do we do it? How do we get ourselves into alignment? Am I communicating? The master is saying, you need to be constrained. You have stayed here enough. It's time to move. Shout, it's time to move. Shout, it's time to move. Shabrakatalabaya. Ladies and gentlemen, I came to understand something very quickly here. That when God begins to introduce some element of challenges and movement, it brings in two major things. You come with me, please. Number one, the Bible says here, verse 24, that the ship was now in the midst of the sea. Shakatayaba. Let me just say three. I look at this scripture and say, excuse me, sir. Why would you go to pray and then send the multitudes away and then constrain your disciples to go? Now they are in the middle of the sea. Jesus Christ. In other words, no choice. This time, if anything happens in the middle of the sea, you can't go back. You can't move forward. You are stuck in the middle of the sea. Have you been through such a situation whereby you come to a dead end? There's no going forward, no going back. Friends, I know something very clearly. I've come too far to go back in this journey. I will not go back. I'm not a cheater. No retreat, no transfer. I know I'm in the middle of the sea. Where am I? Encounter anything whatsoever. But as long as the master sent me, I don't care. Once I'm, the master said, go into the boat and move. Therefore, he sent me upon his word, I am moving. Now I'm in the middle of nowhere in my life, in this journey. Therefore, I don't care. I know it will be very painful and tough to be in the middle of the sea. That would the master who loved me so much allow me to get to the middle of the sea, a point of nowhere. I look back, I can't go to the shore. I look forward, I can't go backward. I'm just in the middle of nowhere. And the master said, move. Master, do you love me? Want to die in the middle of the sea? Friends, most of us have come through a life that way. Whereby we get to the point whereby we're in the middle of nowhere, we are stuck. Moving forward, problem. Backward, problem, difficulty. Yet the master is aware. Tell somebody the master is aware. Shall the master is aware. Tell somebody the master sent me. Tell the master sent me. For we serve the spiritual living God, who the same yesterday, the same today, the same forevermore. If you are studying for them, it's your turn. I say it's your turn. I say it's your turn. I say it's your turn. As long as the master has sent you, don't worry, he got your back. Shall he get my back? Try to do this in this way. No one, the master constrained me only to fight, to leave me in the middle of nowhere. Constraint. Compulsion. I have no choice. I'm stuck. I'm not going to get stuck. What do I do? So if you have been in this country for some years now, you feel like going back. At the same time, someone tells you stay. No, you are just stuck. You can't get to be back in the middle of, you're in the middle of nowhere in America. You have to go back to Nigeria is a problem. To move forward is a problem. You are stuck in the middle of nowhere. It's like, where is my God? I thought you brought me to America for a purpose. Why am I stuck in this land? I have no paper. I have no this. My social is this way. It's not moving very well. Things are not going very well. Do I go back? I can't even go back. Do I just stay? It's a problem. You are just confused and saddled with problems. Oh God, why did I come here? I don't know if you ever asked that question. Why did I come here? Some of you even have your papers, but yet your life is full of sadness and mystery. You don't know where you are going to, where you are coming from. Financially, you are nowhere. Job-wise, you are nowhere. Every family is a problem. Everywhere you turn to is a problem. You are in the middle of nowhere. Some of you have financial issues. You turn to your brother, nowhere. No financial assistance. You turn to your sister, that's nowhere. You say, even little money I've saved. Let me try and manage it. All of a sudden, you under your watch, you are seeing the money you have saved going down, down, down the drain. And at the point, say, God, this money I've saved, why is it going down? What do I do if it goes down? Okay, I have my brother here. Let me call him. But I say, sorry, sister. Sorry, my brother. I'm still managing. You tell your sister, can you help me? My money is going down. Sorry, I'm also managing too. You call your father is nowhere to be found. But there's nowhere to be found. Everywhere you go, you are just stuck. Even what you said, what you thought you have saved enough to lead you, to take you through the next 10 years, is depleted. Job, no job. You are just stuck in love nowhere. Oh God, why did you bring me here? Why did you just stop me in Nigeria? You know, there's some people that want to come over here. For some reason, destiny will stop them. Because here is not for them. Because Nigeria is for them. So for some reason, destiny will stop them. But if you're able to cross over and come over here, for some reason, the destiny is following you. Okay, if destiny is following me, why am I here and I'm stuck? Middle of nowhere. Where do I go? Go back and go back. Stay here is a problem. Am I communicating? Even my financial life is dwindling. I don't know what to do. I serve every day. I read the Bible. I pray. I do everything I could do. Why am I not having a life of fulfillment? What is the problem? I'll let you know. The master is constraining you. The master is constraining you. He's pushing you somewhere. Am I communicating? The greater the pressure, the greater the result. When you take a color, when you take an orange, and you crush it this way, you see more juice. When you crush orange, have you tried before? You crush orange. The more you crush, the more juice comes out. Am I communicating? The master is constraining you, trying to juice you. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. Tell somebody in the middle of nowhere. Now, as if that wasn't enough, as if I've not had enough, still in the middle of nowhere, the Bible says in the next place, the Bible says that of the sea and tossed with waves. Ah, Master, do you actually love me? Are you sure you love me? Are you really sure? That you, the first one we encountered, you were with me in the boat. Yeah, you got me. Everything was fine. Now this time around, you asked me to go. And I obeyed you. Obedience sometimes is tough. I obeyed you. They now leave me in the middle of nowhere. And then, not just that, you now allow under your watch for storm. Bible says here, tossed with waves. Friends, you know what I mean of toss? You know how children are tossed around? They don't know what they're doing. Children, because of their innocence, they're still growing. They've not been able to make proper decisions. So they can be tossed here and they go to their children. Praise God. That's the children. They can be tossed up and down, left and right, everywhere, because they're still children in the level of innocence. Can you read for me Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11 to 14? The book of Ephesians. stays in agreement. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, 4.
11, praise the Lord.
11 to 11, 11 to 14.
It was he who gave some to be apostles, mm-hmm. some to be prophets, some to be evangelists, and some to be pastors and teachers, mm-hmm. to prepare God's people for work of service, so that the body of Christ may be built up, mm-hmm. until we all reach unity in the faith and in the knowledge of the Son of God and become mature, attaining to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ. Then we will no longer be infants, mm-hmm. tossed back and forth by the waves, and yeah. blown here and there by every wind of teaching and by the cunning and craftiness of men in their deceitful scheming.
You see that? Tossed like children. Tossed. That context tells us that Jesus gave us these gifts so that we will not be tossed around anymore. We get matured. So gifts should make you matured. But sometimes gifts can make you mature. Let me put it this way, sorry. Gifts should make you mature because Bible says for the perfection of the saints. That's one of the advantages of having gifts. Perfection of the saints. So that you won't be able to toss like children. You get into full maturity. But those who are not yet mature in use of that gift, the gift toss them around. Am I committed? Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes, we are following.
It's like the opposite. The gift supposed to get you mature, perfect you. Gifts supposed to make you stabilize in one place and serve your God. You are stable. You are stabilized. But gift, if you are not careful, can talk, if you are not mature in use of your gift, to toss you
like
a child. Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
You might think you know this so. Before then, you are there. Yeah. They're not stable. They're not staying to be caught by the world. You're just moving every way. So some people who are not mature, they are tossed with their gift. While some are mature, the gift even make them more mature. Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
So they're not gonna like an adult who has stabilized, dogged and rocket. So the same thing, the same kind of picture we are seeing here, that they were tossed around like infants, immature, with waves. Waves, ladies and gentlemen, represent sin circumstances, things that you can see. A lot of us like finance, marriage. You are married to your husband, you don't want to marry, but then there are waves. There are problems, marital problems. They even lead to divorce. These are waves. These are things you are seeing as storm that you can see. You can even touch it or feel it. You can really, really touch it. These are sin situations, sin circumstances. These are waves. It could be your friends causing persecution for you. These are waves. It could be your parents dealing with these are waves. It could be you are going through some joblessness. These are waves. You are going through some things that are bringing you some restrictions, problems here and there. These are waves. Things that you can touch, you can see with your eyes are waves. Am I communicating? Praise the Lord. So the same way, you can get stuck in the middle of nowhere and be encountering waves. And these waves, by virtue of their definition, will toss you in and there. Financial problem is tossing you. Family issue is tossing you. Am I going to get it? You know, joblessness is tossing you. Instead of you to be rocket what you are doing, you are tossed here and there. You apply it, apply it. I'm not saying you want to apply everywhere. Apply it, apply it. You're not focused. You are tossed around. When you get through to marital situation, you are there. You're not stressing your family. You are just tossed around. Am I going to get it? Praise the Lord. So at this situation, the master wants to take them to where they're supposed to go, their future. But in the middle of the sea, they are being tossed by the waves. They could see the waters rising. Water rising, entering their boats. They could see with their eyes. Typical waves are things you can see. They could see. Waves has to do with storm. They can see water entering the boat. But then, friends, they cannot do anything about it. Sometimes you come to certain things of your life that you are going through problem, you don't know what to do. You are seeing that this is consuming you. You don't know what to do. You're going to get into depression. You know what to do. You are sick. You don't know what to do. Your husband is disturbing. You know what to do. Wife is doing this. You know what to do. They're just in the middle of nowhere with something that is solvable, but you can't do nothing about it. Am I communicating? It's solvable. People can solve it. People are solving it. But you can't do nothing about it. Amen. Am I communicating? These are ways of life. They are seeing what are entering their boat. There's nothing they can do about it. Am I going to get it? Yeah. Let me go to the third one because I'm going to come back to the game. Bible says in third, Bible says, and the wind was contrary. Ladies and gentlemen, is you have storm when there's a strong wind that blows the waters. Am I going to get it?
Yes,
say talk about hurricane. Hurricane comes with speed. It comes with speed. The air about 150 whatever they call it, we blow the water and we bring strong storm. So Bible says here the wind was contrary. So what caused the storm was the wind that was contrary. Oh my God, I thought they said the master is in charge of the wind, charge of the storm. Why is the master praying upon the mountain and storm is against me, the waves are against me, and the this matter, the wind is contrary to me? Why not in my favor? Why is the wind contrary? Am I communicating? Why are situation working against or working for me? What is going on here? One, in the middle of nowhere. Two, storms. I can see water in the machine. I could do something about it. I couldn't do anything about it. Now is the wind causing the storm for me. And the master is there on the mountain praying. Praying. And you allow the storm against me? You allow the wind to be contrary. I thought they said the master is in charge of the wind. Why not pray that the wind with my favor instead of being against me? Tonight I declare every wind contrary to you is hereby destroyed. The Bible says Colossians chapter 2. Ale brakata. Makotoli brakata shekete. Makatoli brigate. Masokotoli brakata. Mali brakato shekete babaya. Apalikatalabaya. Jump, print on. Masokotoli brigade. Mali brakato shakata. Mali brakato shekete. Jump, print on. My life, every storm against my life, every wave against my situation. Your time is up. Your time is up. Your time is up. Your time is up. Zebrakata la brakade. Eshakatoli brigade. Mayandali brigade. Makotoli brigade. Mayandali brigade. Mayandolo brakato. Eshakatoli brigade. Mayandolo babalagado. Eye mama. Your time is up. 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 Zebrakatoli baga. Makotoli shabaga. Oh, your time is up. Oh my God, my God, the force of our mentor. In the name of Jesus. Colossians chapter 2, verse 14. Blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was against us, which was contrary to us. Contrary. The wind was contrary. But the Bible says he blots it out. And you can see that he blots it out. Why did Jesus allow me to go through things contrary to me? Bible says Colossians chapter 2, verse 14, that he blots it out. Why was I allowed to encounter these things? Why did the master blotting it out? What was the problem? The master is controlling you. He's taking you somewhere. And Bible says he took it out of the way. He took this thing out of the way. Not because of Calvary. And my congregation, having spoiled principles and powers, he made a show of them openly, triumphing over them in it. And my congregation, oh my God, friends, that you are going through the waves and the winds, if I look as if it's consuming you, don't worry. Colossians chapter 2, verse 14 is working. You might not see it right now, but it's working. And my congregation is blotting out some things contrary to you. If I look as if it's going to consume you, don't worry. Colossians chapter 2, verse 14 is working. Bible says he took it out of your way. So everything contrary to you, the master will take out of your way. Out of your way. Out of your way. Every way contrary against you, out of your way. 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 Marco Taba. Listen, gentlemen, the name of Jesus. Friends, way contrary against you has the world stopping you. They were supposed to move to the next part of the life, next phase of the life, to cross over. But the wind came purposely to stop them. The Bible says it was contrary. In other words, they tried to move forward, the wind came against them. Am I confused? Have you seen the picture? They had to move forward, it came against them. So they were in a deep problem. Have you been through problems? Front, no way. Back, no way. Sideways, no way. In other words, what do I do? Have you got a point in your life when you ask yourself a question? Ask yourself a question, what do I do? Where do I go from here? I'm troubled on every side. Difficulties everywhere. I try to move even the wind itself is working against me. But when we're supposed to work in my favor, is that working against me? Winds represent unforeseen circumstances. Why winds represent sin circumstances? So the same things I'm seeing, financial, family, children, husband, it's causing some issues against, working against me, doing certain things against me I don't like. No, not favorable to me. At the same time, I say if I've not had enough, then all for see things are working against me. Witches are there working against me. Strong men are there working against me. Powers are working against me. For a village, they are throwing some stones against me. They are throwing javelin and sword against me. Throwing shots against me. Afternoon, night, everywhere, problem everywhere. Why am I under this situation? Am I the only one in this world? Why? I've had others are making good. These are working for them. Why not me? Why are winds contrary to me? What have I done? What have I done? What have I done? I'm just believing with the fact that I'm middle of nowhere. Then storm is working against me. Things I can control, I can no longer control it. At this job, I can look for job, but job is not looking for me. I can't control it. It's my family is breaking down. I can control it, but I'm not controlling it. Things are happening, these are waves. Amen? My children, they are getting here and there. They are not listening to me. I could control it, but why am I not controlling it? This is, you can control these things. On top of that, I'm not having winds I cannot see against my destiny. Yet I'm told to move over to the other side of the region. How do I go? Where do I go from here? Am I communicating? Kawaya. So, kawaya. Aya baba. Bible says in verse 25, in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went on to them. Walking on the sea. Can I preach it now? I want to start preaching now. Start preaching now. So I can end quickly. Ladies and gentlemen, the first watch of your night. Yes, I've seen my time. I've seen it already. My watch is here. Amen. I know my preaching and my prayer. I know how to supposed to end. I'm looking at my watch, okay? I will, even if I pray for 10 minutes, let me just, okay. Yeah. Amen. Amen. I'm watching my time here, don't worry. Hallelujah. Hey. Let me run up. Hallelujah. Ladies and gentlemen, the first watch of the night, when Romans took over the Jewish land, they imposed their watches over them. So apart from the hours, we see that Jesus mentioned 12 hours of the day, man should walk, the Romans also brought their own watches at night. Amen. Amen. You know, the moron gave them first watch of the night, second watch of the night, third watch of the night, and then fourth watch of the night. Amen. Kali Bragadu Shaba. Fourth watch of the first watch of the night, usually from 6 a.m. Amen. Amen. To what time? So we have 6, 7, 8, 12. Second watch is what?
The third.
The third. Third watch is what? Now and then from 6 till 3 a.m. is what? No, 3 a.m. to 6 is the fourth watch. So which means at this point, the master was from the first watch or the second watch. Because we say it was evening. Am I going to get it? He was there praying. It could be first, third watch. Am I going to get it? But the point I'm trying to make is that he left these people hanging in there. First watch, second watch, third watch, we don't know exactly the watch he was there, but he left them for long. At least he left them for during the third watch. He now came to the fourth watch. We don't know whether it was second watch or third watch, but we are sure it is third watch because he came at the fourth watch. Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that we're not going to error. Even if it's first watch, second watch, but we know that he met them at his fourth watch. Friends, at the fourth watch of people's life, they go through, that's your time of what I call infancy, when you are dependent on people, dependent on things. You know, at this time, the apostles now find some solace on Jesus. Everything is master, give me food, give me this, give me chewing gum, give me this one. That's the first watch, like a baby, an infant, tossed around. Second watch, you are beginning to grow a little bit. Third watch, the master begins to bring you to a place of perfection. Am I communicating? And the third watch of your life, it sends you on a journey. All by yourself. The first watch is with you. It carries like a baby, and the mother will carry his baby. The Bible says, Peter, don't worry. And the devil came to seek for assistance, for help for me to sift you. Don't worry. I know, I don't know, I don't want to stop the sifting. I don't want to stop it. But I know what I will do. I will pray for your faith. Once your faith is strong, you overcome the sifting. Don't worry. I won't stop the sifting because I know you need it. You go through it and get stronger, but your faith will be strong. I'm praying for your faith. Am I coming here? I don't come here to the case of life. I can let you know the owner of the sea is here. The owner of the storm is here. He's walking towards you. He's walking towards you. He's walking towards you. Shout out.
hear you well, well. I submit to anything, God. Don't be saved yesterday, be saved today, be saved forevermore. If God has done it for them, it's your turn. Shut up, my fourth watch of life. First, this is time for your miracles. You're your fourth watcher. You're your fourth watcher. The master is walking towards you. The master is walking towards you. Your fourth watch has come. Your fourth watch has come. Your fourth watch. The third watch is over. Weeping may endure to the night. But there coming joy when the fourth watch arrives. Your fourth watch has come. Your fourth watch has come. This is your turn. This is your turn. This is your turn. Shout good morning. What is your money time? Your money has come. You have gone through the night season. I'm tired of this problem and difficulties. Oh, Master, come to me. Oh, Master, come to me. Oh, Master, come to me. I am tired of this life. The third watch overwhelmed me. But fourth watch is my time. Fourth watch is my time. There's somebody, your time has come. Oh, be able to pray. My time has come. I'm in my fourth watch. Nobody can stop me. No witch can stop me. No wizard can stop me. I'm in my fourth watch of life. My money has come. There's somebody good money. My money has come. My money has come. Ah, yaga dala. Oh, puya madam prosper.
Baba, 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 baba
Bible again? Where I'm standing, we're praying. We're praying already. Matthew chapter 14, verse 26. Take your Bible. You know, I like to read the Bible to pray. Take your Bible. Oh, the master. Bible says, verse 26, and when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, it is a spirit. And they cried out for fear. Ladies and gentlemen, I was looking at this. I said, what is the difference? Jesus. Jesus. What is the difference between the appearance of Jesus and even his voice at this time and when they just fed 5,000 not long ago? Maybe during the second watch of the night. Whatever it is. Second watch or first watch. I don't know. Whatever it is. Am I communicating? What is the difference between his appearance and his voice at this time on the sea in the middle of nowhere? And then when they were feeding the 5,000, what was the difference? They saw him and they said, it's a spirit. And he said, it is be not afraid. So appearance and voice, they could not recognize him. They didn't know it was one. And my God, friends, can I give you a shocker?
Yes.
When the master is taking you and constraining you to other side of your life, to give you an edge in this world, you need a new encounter to enter your new phase of life. In other words, the time they fed 5,000, his voice should be different. It should be different voice. His appearance should be different. Remember the Mount of Transfiguration? When he got water, it wasn't what they saw him before. Yeah, it was now. So each time Jesus comes up with a new face, it changes. It's called transformation. It's not what you see yesterday, you see today. Why? You are going through transformation. That's why you cannot remain the same again. What you are today should not be what you are tomorrow. Then you don't understand the master. Say, master, you have changed. You are like a spirit. You don't understand your voice anymore. Friends, in the point of encounter, everything changes.
Amen.
Oh Lord, change my life.
Oh Lord, change my life.
Change everything about me. Do I talk? Do I do things? Transform me. Transform me. There must be a proof of encounter. If I encounter you, there must be a proof. If Jesus encounters, there must be a proof. There must be a transformation. It should not be the way I met you yesterday. Today should be different from yesterday. Some of us, we are the same every day. No changes. No changes. No. That is not a counter. That is not transformation. My name, Brakato Sakata. Ye Brakato Sekete. Ye Brakato Sakata. My name, Brakato Sekete. Ye Brakato Sekete. My name, Brakato Sakata. Ye Brakato Sekete. Ye Brakata. I am the Lord, Brakato Sekete. Ye Brakato Sakata. My name, Brakato Sekete. My name, Brakato. Oh Lord, transform my life. Oh Lord, transform my life.
I'm tired of this life, of this kind of life.
transform my life, transform my destiny, transform my life, transform my destiny. Oh, give me a new life, give me a new life, give me a new life, give me a new life. And Peter answered him and said, Lord, if it be thou, bid me come unto thee on waters. Verse 29, and he said, come. And when Peter was come down out of the ship, he walked on the waters to go to Jesus. You see what constraint can do? Oh, Master Rider! Constraint. Put me under alignment. upon the alignment. No, it will work out for my good. 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 In the name of Jesus. Friends, I wish I had time to preach this. It just went in my mind. Let me say this very politely because of time. Listen to this very carefully. Oh my God. Listen, listen. Friends, the devil might have the storm waves. Listen, listen. But you got the word. I wish I had more time. The devil might have the storm and the winds and waves. Contrary to you, but you have the word. Peter told us, so if you had the word, bid me to come. He said, come. That come was God's word. Peter stood on God's word and began to walk. With God, all things are possible. Walk on this forward until we get the result. As a master walking towards towards you, they're walking towards him. Power to two of you jump. Power with that power. Jesus will jam you. I pray in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray for you that the grace and tenacity to keep walking on the word of God.
Amen.
Not getting discouraged.
Amen.
Not getting tired.
Yes, Lord.
Keep walking at it.
Amen.
Keep walking on the force of alignment.
Amen.
Until you get your result.
Yes, Lord.
Keep walking.
Yes, Lord.
Keep walking.
Yes, Lord.
Keep walking.
Yes, Lord.
Receive the grace to walk.
I receive it.
Receive the grace to walk on the word.
I receive it in Jesus.
All the days of your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I come against the spirit of discouragement. The spirit of tiredness.
I
rebuke it.
I
cast it out. I release you into a force of alignment. Force of alignment. Force of alignment. Force of alignment. The master will constrain you to take you higher. To take you higher. To take you higher. From today, I declare you are going higher. You are going higher. You are going higher. You are going higher. In the name of Jesus, receive it now. Receive it now. Receive it now. Power to go higher.
Yes,
power to go higher.
Yes,
power to go higher. The realm of the spirit. The realm of the physical. Go higher. In your finance. In your health. In your fellowship. Go higher. In your family. Go higher. Power to go higher. Receive it now. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Those of you on the line here, if you are sick, be healed now. Under the force of alignment, be healed now. Be healed now. Be healed now. I cause that sickness. I cause that disease. I command to come out. I cause pain and cause you. Come out in Jesus' name. Everything you believe God for, everything you trust God for, tonight receive your miracles. 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 Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Shout amen.
Amen.
Somebody, your time has come. That 3%, this your fourth watch. Your time has come.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
My goodness.
Yes, Lord.
Praise the Lord. Hey. Everybody is holding. Nobody wants to sit.
No, we are not tired.
It is too, I'm telling you, it is too hot to be. Oh my God. It can, I'm telling you. Praise the Lord. I say, today you see I get from Mike Expo. Nobody, sure you remember me saying our faces will turn to something.
Yes,
you see?
Yeah, you
so is so what God have done today is prophetic.
Yes,
so that as you're opening your door, people that know you will no longer know you again. Something have changed, amen. Oh, what can we do with our brother? My sisters, just everybody, let's just stretch your hand. Just begin to bless him, that he will be the first partaker, that the Lord will do him well, that the Lord will increase him, oh, that the Lord will beautify him, and that, oh my God, right now he is swimming in the fourth level, in the fourth wash. Our brother is in the fourth wash. Oh, the Lord has pushed him from, oh my God, to the fourth wash, where he is with Jesus, where he is walking on the word, where he's saying, as long as Jesus is with me, speak, Master, and it shall be done. Oh, speak, Master, and it shall be done. And as our Master is speaking unto him, it is being done. It is done already. Everything that is cooking in his life, every situation, every circumstance, even the wind has been stopped. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, thank you. Thank you for your son. Thank you, Abba Father, Lord. We bless you. We bless you, Abba Father, even as he has blessed us tonight. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen, amen, amen. Offering time. Offering time. Blessing time. The Lord loves a cheerful giver. Amen. Our Holy Ghost voices, we are ready. Amen. 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 If you're not ready, I can begin. Are you all ready? I beg.
Thank you.
I don't want the fellowship to leave now, I beg. When we have collected the
Hallelujah.
is good. Just stretch your hand and bless the offering. Father, Lord, we thank you. Father, bless our hand. Bless this offering. Bless everyone that have given. Even the ones that want to give but don't have, Lord, you will bless them. Father, as you will bless, oh Lord, oh God, we will continue to come to your sanctuary. Thank you for all your daughters that, oh Lord, and your sons who have used mightily tonight. God bless them in the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Wow, we are doing good. God is good. God is good. Yes. Hallelujah. And at this time, I want to call your one and only, your beautiful assistant, coordinator, Wenshi. God forgive me. You know, I love to just sit back and, you know, and just sit and quiet, but God just, you know, is always pulling me out too. So anyway, so here comes your own and humble self. Yes, look at these kids, cannot contain themselves. Love it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We are blessed tonight. Amen. Yes, yes. It is good to be in the presence of the Lord. It is joyful. It is just too joyful. The Lord have done mighty things for us. And we thank you, everyone who have come. All that have allowed the Lord to use them tonight. Bless the holy name of the Lord. Amen. And we want to especially thank our, my Holy Ghost voices. I've been praising you all tonight, oh, so please, oh, please, I don't want to say anything, but I want to give a special thanks to our own sister Ngozi, you know, who was not prepared to even give us open charge, and the Lord used her mightily. So we want to thank you, sister Ngozi, for that. Yes, yes, hallelujah. And we want to thank all our Holy Ghost voices, Sister Ifi, I want to thank you so much. Every time I hear your voice, the thing is taking me to heaven. So I thank God for that voice. Amen. It looks like Sister Ifi, Ifi is taking over. Sister Rita, Sister Ifi, you guys don't let her.
You are telling them to work on me. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And I thank God for our beautiful instrumentalists here. You know, it's good. Please, let's clap for them. They did a good job today. Let me tell you what happens. Sometimes, if you notice that people have too much free time, you give them extra work. You know, I used to do that when I work and I see my staff and I see that they're taking too, you know, playing too much in the, I will go to one of the administrators and I'll say, it looks like they don't have enough work. And before you know it, they will call you and give you another. So, you know, today they were here sitting. You know why? They didn't move at all. Because now they are now videoing us and taking pictures and everything. Praise the Lord! So they didn't have time to move. Brother Mike, you will give them this assignment though. We declare it permanent in Jesus' name. So everything that was happening in this, they took note. They didn't move. Ah, it's good to have extra job. May God give us extra job that we will not work hard for in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. So I just want to thank everyone, all the testifiers. Remember, our global line continues to be on fire. Amen? Amen. Please don't miss it. Don't miss it. God is doing mighty things. All the leaders of the global line, all those that are on the line, God bless you. God have changed our story. God have elevated our level. Amen. We will no longer be noticed in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Sister, who will close us out? My dear, just come and bless us. See, you've been laughing too much over my joke, so come and bless us. Amen. Let me clean the thing. Just bless your mother. Say, God, help them to make too much money so we can buy you too much stuff. Praise the Lord. And share also.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Can we be on our feet?
Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, King of Glory. Thank you for today.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank you for the life you've given to us. Make us to come here and pray. Nothing happened to every one of us. We are safe and sound. Lord, we thank you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, Lord, for the things we have received today from the Mike, Lord, King of Liberty, manifest in our life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May we never leave anyone apart. May everything manifest in our life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And may we use it and learn from others in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Hallelujah. You are on fire. Yes, as you have blessed us, the Lord will bless you all the days of your life. You will go higher and higher. Your nation, your community, you will be sorted after everywhere you go. Let the favor of the Lord bestow you and your family in Jesus' name. May we share the grace in fellowship. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be and abide with us now and forever among us. Amen. Before we do, surely, somebody brought some beautiful food.
Yeah, okay.
Too much food. My sister. So today we had spiritual feeling and also physical one. And that was brought by our sister, Sister Ngozi. She said she wants to thank us for just being there for her when she lost her dad. Holy Ghost Fellowship, I'm so proud of us. You know, if people that are here, you don't even need any organization. Look at last week, the hall was filled up. Anytime anybody calls us, we will be together because we won't just speak love, we will act love. Amen? Love is our name. Holy Ghost plus love. It was the presence of God. It was the might of the Lord. It was the overflowing of the Lord. My sister, may God bless you. And our welfare minister is here, leader, waiting to help us, our sister Henrietta, all the good work you're doing. You know, those are the ministries that are not being seen all the time. You know, we see the beautiful choir ministers all the time, you know, and we see, but we don't see them. God bless you, ma'am. May God continue to just do, you know, and then every time they come to share food here, there is no wahala. There is no problem. Everybody is smiling. May you smile all the days of your life. May God will make your family, your children, everything you're doing for Holy Ghost Fellowship, you will smile. That everybody will become envious of you in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. Okay, we have some food. Please, when you are leaving, just up at our table. We'll collect your food. Okay, praise the Lord.